Wow. Are you glad to be in the house of God this morning? Come on, give God a mighty shout of praise. Give him a shout of praise. Woo! Pastor Chris, I can't thank you enough for your heart for us and for pouring into us like that. We need that. And I'm telling you, that Kenzie is special. Man, thank you for that word. That was powerful. And God was just, he's just, I don't know, I think sometimes we're God's favorite. In fact, I think I know we're God's favorite because he does special stuff like this. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody just give him worship right now. Just out of your, in your own way, just worship him. Just honor him. I'm just full right now. My heart's just full. God, I thank you for what you're doing. And God, we are going to magnify you. Even now, we praise and lift you up. We give you glory. God, we worship you in spirit and truth. God, we pour out our heart to you today. For you are worthy in Jesus' name. You are worthy. You are worthy of our praise today. Hallelujah. Amen. Give about three people a high five and tell them it's good to see you. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Somebody shout joy. Say it again, joy. This is a joyful season, and we're going to rejoice in the Lord. We're going to magnify him because the joy of the Lord is our strength. Are you ready to rejoice? Let's go.
Beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness.
We've been made a door for a night. Joy comes in the morning. Joy unspeakable, full of glory. Joy unspeakable, full of glory. Of glory.
Joy unspeakable and full of glory.
Full of glory.
on, let's celebrate, magnify him together. Come on.
What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn every morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn every morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn every morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn every morning into dancing. What you've
sown in tears, you will reap in joy.
Turn every morning
into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn every morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn every morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn every morning joy. Turn in your morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn in your morning into dancing. What you've
sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn in your morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turn in your morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. He's turning your morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turning your morning into dancing. What
you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turning your morning into dancing. What you've sown in tears, you will reap in joy. Turning your morning into dancing.
What you've
sown in tears, you will
shout. One more time, give him praise, everybody. Come on. Hallelujah. Well, we've come, as Pastor Chris said, to spend our Christmas gathering, our Christmas season with you. And we're so excited. I'm so blessed that Chris allowed us to come and be a part of his family. And well, we're all family, amen. We are family. Yeah. So for those of y'all who are kind of processing what is all of this, God has given our ministry such an amazing opportunity to share Jesus all over the world. And we literally do that. In fact, we were just in Samoa, and that was absolutely incredible. And then we've been here in Hawaii for the last week or so, releasing Jesus in different parts of this beautiful state. And I've been to Israel and Nigeria and Kenya and Belize. It's just been an amazing season of ministry. But along with that, we have a ministry called Dream Life. Everybody shout Dream Life. It's a ministry where high school and college age youth come to us out of drug addiction, street life, gangs, and violence. And for many of them to sustain victory, they need a different environment to live in. And God has blessed us. We have a place in Cleveland, Tennessee, 10 acres of land on a river, and about 40 young people live there full time. And many have come as a result of our Dream Life program, and God is moving among our young people. Come on, give God praise for that. Amen. And so, and because of what we do, sometimes there are those who don't go home, they spend Christmas with me. And so we were excited to say, okay, we're going to spend Christmas together, and we're going to come to Hawaii and do it. Amen. So we're so grateful. So in celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ, because he is still the reason for the season, if you believe that, say amen. I want to do a couple of songs in our worship gathering, songs that I've written that tell the Christmas story. Are we ready for it? So we're going to do a couple of songs about that. Here we go. Let's go.
All the way from heaven down, of whom the angels
and the glory and the honor and the power and the praise. and the praise. To him be all the blessing and the glory and the honor and the power and
come on,
the praise. To him be all the blessing and the glory and the honor and the power and the praise. To him be all the blessing and the glory and the honor and the power and the praise. To give me all the blessing and the glory and the honor and the power and the praise. To give me all the blessing and the glory and the honor and the power and the praise. To give me all the blessing and the glory and the honor and the power and the praise. To give me all the blessing and the glory and the honor and the power and the praise. To give me all the blessing and the glory and the honor and the power.
Worship Him.
Worship Him.
Exalt Him.
Exalt Him.
Let all the earth.
Let all the earth proclaim.
Say Jesus.
Jesus.
What's His name?
Jesus,
my Savior,
Jesus,
King of Kings,
Jesus,
Lord of Lords,
Jesus,
mighty God,
Jesus,
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 hey,
Jesus is His name, Jesus.
Christ, when they have found the place and they beheld His face, they all the nation, healer, redeemer, and divine deliverer, defense and conqueror. He's he, my chain breaker. He will set the captives free.
For the creation, giver of salvation,
he,
hope of the nation,
healer, redeemer,
and divine
deliverer,
defense and conqueror.
He's he,
my chain breaker.
us dead.
Under heaven, whereby we must be saved. From age to age, there is a name put above all names. With the throne of
Jesus,
no other name. Under heaven, whereby we must be saved. From age to age, there is a name put above all names. With the throne of the name of
Jesus,
no other name.
Jesus,
there is no other name. Under heaven, whereby we must be saved. From age to age, there is a name put above all names. But there's no other name but
Jesus.
No other name but
Jesus.
Jesus. No other name under heaven, whereby we must be saved. From age to age, there is a name above all names. But there's no other name but
Jesus.
God of the breakthrough, when I can't see my way through, and
to say breakthrough, 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 breakthrough. I declare in the name of Jesus, everything that stands between you and what God has promised you breaks in Jesus' name. No more hindrances, no more setbacks, no more delays. God is bringing you into your promise. Jericho walls are falling. Somebody shout, breakthrough! Breakthrough in my heart, breakthrough in my mind, breakthrough in my spirit, breakthrough in my soul, breakthrough in my weakness, breakthrough in my struggle. You are the God. You are the God of the breakthrough in my worship, breakthrough in my praise, breakthrough with my lips and glorify your name, breakthrough when I dance, breakthrough when I shout. You are the God. You are the God of the
breakthrough in my heart, breakthrough in my mind, breakthrough in my spirit, breakthrough in my soul, breakthrough in my weakness, breakthrough in my struggle.
Breakthrough in my praise, breakthrough with my lips, glorify your name, breakthrough in a dance, breakthrough in a shout.
Breakthrough when I dance, breakthrough when I shout.
Hallelujah. Oh, give him a shout today. Give him a shout. Woo. We bless you today, Jesus. Declares that death and life is in the power of the tongue. This morning, I want us to use our tongue to declare what God says about us. I want to bless our family, bless our church, bless this city, and bless this nation. I want you to join with me in doing this. So I want you to repeat after me. Lift your voice and help me say this.
My house
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My family
is blessed. Is blessed.
My health
is blessed. Is blessed.
My wealth
is blessed. Is blessed.
My church
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My city
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My nation
is blessed.
Is blessed.
For my God
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My house
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My family
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My health
is blessed.
Is blessed.
And
my wealth
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My church
is blessed.
Is blessed.
And my city
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My nation
is blessed.
From my God. Come on.
Is blessed.
Hallelujah.
My health
is blessed.
Is blessed.
And
my wealth
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My church
is blessed.
Is blessed.
And
my city
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My nation
thank
you, Jesus,
is blessed.
For my God.
For my God.
One more time, say,
my house
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My family
is blessed.
Is blessed.
My health
is blessed.
Celebrate.
For my God.
Come on.
Hallelujah, I'm blessed.
Hallelujah, I'm blessed.
Somebody praise the blesser today. If you believe you're blessed, give God a mighty shout of praise right now. God, we honor you today. We give you glory. We've come to worship you, Jesus. We praise and we lift you high today. We magnify you, God.
I have never known someone like you. You are so amazing and so true. Never could have dreamed that this would be, that the God of all the earth would dwell in me.
You are so beautiful to me. You're the only God in whom I believe. In your presence I want to stay forever. Cause when I'm with you, things get better and better.
So I praise and lift you high, God of water, earth, and sky.
You are so amazing and so true. I never could have dreamed that this could be, that the God of all the earth would dwell in me, yeah.
You are so beautiful to me. You're the only God in whom I believe. In your presence I gotta stay forever. Because when I'm with you, things get better and better.
So I praise and lift you high, God of water, earth, and sky, God of glory, power, and might. You are holy, you are worthy, so I praise and lift you high. You are Savior and Lord of my life, and with tears of worship I cry. You are holy, you are worthy, so I praise. God of water, earth,
so I praise and lift you high. You are Savior and Lord of my life. And with tears of worship I cry, you are holy, you are worthy.
So I praise and I lift you
high.
I praise and I lift you
high.
I praise and I lift you high.
I
praise and I lift you
high.
I praise and I lift you high.
I
praise and I lift you high.
I lift
you high.
You are holy.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
So I praise and I lift you high.
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 I praise and I lift you high. You are holy.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
I praise and I lift you high.
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 There was nobody like you, Lord, in the heavens or the earth. We give you all the glory, because you are a matchless king, God of restoration.
You are holy,
you are worthy. So I praise and I lift you high, the King of glory. Lord God, strong and mighty,
you
are mighty in battle. We give you glory, we praise you, we praise your name.
You are holy,
you are worthy.
I praise and I lift you,
I praise and I lift you high.
I praise and I lift you,
I praise and I lift you high.
I praise and I lift you,
I praise and I lift you high.
I praise and I lift you,
I praise and I lift you high.
I praise and I lift you,
I praise and I lift you high.
I praise and I lift you,
I praise and I lift you high.
Wow, come on, give God one more clap offering of praise. Take your seat for just a second. One of the core messages, I would like to say it this way, one of the core revelations that God has given to our team, and I'm sure that you all can bear witness with this, is that we are sons and daughters of the living God. And it's so important that we don't forget that. I'm looking at some of the children that are here, and I'm seeing how people are caring for them. I'm assuming that these are moms and dads that are holding and loving on their children. And one of the things that I grasp when I see that is how when the children came into the world or came into their parents' life, a good mother, a good father does not love them based on what they bring to the table. In fact, usually when they come into the world, for the most part, they cost everything. It comes with a cost, you know. And then they spit up, they poop, they have to feed them. But something in your heart just says, man, I'm so in love with this child. And I see that, I feel that when it comes to the father, that when I cost him everything, but yet he loved me still. How many of you are glad for the love of the Father in your life? How many of you are grateful for the love of the Father? 80% to 90% of the young people that we rescue either don't have a father in their life or have a horrible relationship with him. And this revelation is key because our identity is found in him. That's who we learn who we are. And for this season, for some, this would be the greatest celebration all year. And for some, this could be the most depressing. Now, I don't know where you find yourself in the middle of that, but I want you to be filled with joy as the revelation of the Father is released to you today. You will know that you're not forgotten, as the word went forth over Kinsey. I just want to echo that for everyone in this room. You have a father who looks at you as the apple of his eye. You are beautiful to him. Oh, his thoughts towards you is more than the sand on the sea. And every thought is just how much he loves you, what he has planned for you, what he's designed for you. We have a good, good father. If you believe that, say amen. I want you to be blessed by this presentation that these young men just beautifully presents just how the Father loves us and how you no longer have to be a slave because you're a son, you're a daughter. Say amen.
Unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer slave to fear, for I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave. For I am a child of God. For from my mother's womb. You have chosen me. Love has called my name. And I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. Oh, I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. Yeah, yeah, la shakia. I'm no longer a slave to fear. Oh, for I am a child of God. I am no longer a slave. Child of Abba, you are a child of God. Ayala Bokoshaya.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Abba, Abba, I have a Father who really loves me. Abba, Abba, He'll never leave me, never forsake me. Abba, Abba. Since I've been born again, I have been grafted in. So undeserving, and yet, in spite of my sin, He loved me and He called me His. I am His very own. Through His love, I've been changed. Now I proclaim, Abba, Abba. Since I've been baptized, I've taken on the name of Christ. He gave me my identity, and now I'm free from every generational curse, because of Him it's been reversed. I am joint heirs with Jesus, so I proclaim, Abba, Abba. Taking on the name of Christ, He gave you your identity. So now you're free from every generational curse. Because of Him, it's been reversed. You are joined as with Jesus. So let's proclaim, Abba, Abba.
Protects me, Abba Father. Directs me, Abba Father. Provides for me and never ever leave me, Abba Father. Loves me, Abba Father. Holds me, Abba Father. Keeps me, Abba Father. Takes care of me, Abba Father. Protects me, Abba Father. Directs me, Abba Father. Provides for me
He'll never ever leave me. I'm a father. He loves me. I'm a father. He holds me. I'm a father. Keeps me. I'm a father. Takes care of me. I'm a father. Protects me. I'm a father. Directs me. I'm a father. Provides for me. He'll never ever leave me.
That's who I am.
So I am. So I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. Glorify your name, Abba. Abba. Worship you, Abba.
spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me.
Love of God, oh, it chases me down.
still I'm from least to 99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve it. Still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. Against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace, it's overwhelming. I wanna sit at your feet. Drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace, it's overwhelming. I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your peace, it's
walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall. But you have never failed me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, for you have never failed me yet. Your promise still stands, great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never failed me yet. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence.
Still in your hands, this is my confidence. You never failed me yet. 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 You never failed. You never failed me.
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 You never failed.
You never failed me.
Found me.
You never found me.
It's not in you to
You never fail me.
It's not in you to fail me.
You never fail
me. You said you'd be right there with me everywhere that I go.
Never fail me.
When I ran from you, God, you never fail me.
You never fail me.
And you never fail me.
You never fail me.
Yes and amen. Yes and amen.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yes and amen. Yes and amen. Your promises.
Yes and amen. Yes and amen. Yes and amen.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes and amen.
Your promises.
Yes and amen.
Yes and amen. I dare you to declare this over your life.
Yes and amen.
Yes and amen.
Yes and amen.
Your promises are
yes and amen. Yes and amen. Yes and amen.
Come on, one last time.
Yes and amen.
Your promise still stands. Your promise still stands.
Great is your faithfulness.
Come on, sing it out.
Your faithfulness. Stealing your hands. This is my confidence. You've never.
Come on, sing it. Say your promise still stands. And great is your
faithfulness.
Your faithfulness.
Faithfulness.
We are still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never failed me.
My wife went years without seeing me cry. Something about Jesus turns me into a crybaby. This is a very tough song for me because this is a song that my brother would play in the hospital as he was dying of cancer. And we would sing it and we would believe that God wouldn't fail us, and we kind of sang it believing for the future, for his healing. And I'm sitting here and somebody just came and gave me a word about, since my brother's died, there have been moments where I felt like I was doing this alone because he was my partner, and I know I'm not doing it alone, but there are times in the silence when I say, I wish you were here. And it's so hard. To sing songs like this and think back on your life at all the ways that you failed and all of your disappointments And it's easy to sing. It's really hard to believe statements like you've never failed me yet, not when you've experienced disappointment, not when you've prayed a million prayers and sometimes they don't get answered.
Come on, man.
I can sing, "You won't fail me," because I always have hope for the future. But to say, "You have never failed me yet." It's the holiday season. We're about to celebrate Christmas, and you're going to spend it with your families, and we're going to open gifts. We're going to exchange gifts. And I was standing here and I was watching Robbie Jean run around and run up the stage and down the stage. And Lay is just shouting out to God for 60 seconds at a time. I don't know how she does it. And I can feel people in the room saying, "Is that really necessary?" And it's funny because if I go to a football game and somebody's running up and down the stairs, I don't think anything crazy about that. When I'm at a football game or a concert, somebody's screaming for 60 minutes at a time, I don't think there's anything crazy about that. But then we get in church and we get in the presence of God and we say, "Is that all necessary?" And I don't know when it became the church thing to do, where emotionally compromised people became the experts on what God wants and doesn't want.
Wow.
I don't understand how we came to live in a world in which people who have misplaced priorities and passions get to tell me what kind of passion God does and doesn't want. And I think that there's a new generation that's rising. And you were a generation that was called rebellious, just like I was. I was a hellraiser. As a kid, I was called rebellious. I always asked why. I questioned everything. I went to Bible college. They couldn't wait for me to leave because I argued with my professors every single day. And they said I was rebellious. My wife was the poster child for my Bible college. When they found out we were engaged, professors tried to talk her out of it because I was the biggest troublemaker. Love Jesus. And everywhere the establishment told me that I was rebellious and that I needed to get that out of me, only to realize as I began to run after Jesus that it was everything that he made me. And I believe that there's an entire generation that's crying out, that's saying, "We don't want emotionally compromised people, and people with misplaced passions, organizations, buildings, religions to tell us that we can't run after God as hard as we want to run after him. To tell us that one day a week is the only day that we serve Jesus. He came, he died for messy people, messy lives. And until he comes back, it's just going to be messy. We will succeed. We will fail. We'll aim high. We'll miss the mark. And through it all, 2,000 years ago, God saw all of it, sent his son, because he loves us. Your life may be messy till the day that you die. But I know he won't fail you, because he hasn't failed you yet. How do I know this? I've told this story a million times. My favorite character in the Bible is Paul, by a mile. I wanted to be a lawyer growing up. He was an expert in the law, and the way that he writes just feels like the way my head thinks. But there's this funny thing about Paul. We remember Paul. Paul was awesome. And we mythologize Paul. Paul's the greatest believer of all time. Wrote 2/3 of the Bible. But we forget about Saul. As great as Paul was, as mythological as Paul is, that's how bad a sinner he was. He was a murderer. And not just a serial killer. He was a serial killer of believers. He hunted down followers of Jesus, and with state-sanctioned authority, he murdered them. And the most famous murder, possibly in the history of the church, is the murder of a man named Stephen. It's a story that lives on in Acts forever. Acts chapter 8, he's murdered. And when they murder Stephen, they take his clothes and they lay it down in reverence at the feet of the guy who ordered the murder, a guy named Saul. The greatest single sin in Acts, the greatest single sin recorded in the history of the early church, that you find in the Bible, is the murder of Stephen. And just before he dies, Stephen says this to everyone around him. He says, "The God of heaven does not live in a house made by human hands." You can't contain him. You can try, but he will never reside in man-made ideas, man-made paradigms, man-made traditions.
That's so good.
Man-made ways of thinking. The God of heaven does not live in a house made by human hands.
Come on.
That young man Saul heard those words on the day he committed his greatest sin. Saul meets Jesus miraculously. Changes his name, changes his life. Goes all over the world. Instead of killing believers, he starts making believers. And in his journeys, one day, decades later, he finds himself in the most philosophical city in the world, the great city where all of the religions of the earth converge to debate Athens, Greece. And there's a specific spot in Athens called Mars Hill where the philosophers would gather, the greatest minds of their time, and they would debate religion and philosophy. They pull Paul up there and they said, "Explain to us this crazy thing that you're teaching us." In that moment, standing before the greatest minds in the entire world at that time, he preaches his greatest message, and he doesn't use a single scripture verse. He says this is the center of his message. Standing in front of all those minds, he says this: "The God of heaven does not live in a house made by human hands."
Wow.
On the day he gives his greatest message, the pinnacle of his ministry, he preaches a truth that he learned.
Yes, sir.
On the day of his greatest mistake. He could have preached anything.
That's crazy.
You can't redo your past. But God will always redeem your past. That's why He doesn't fail you. There is purpose to the pain that you've gone through.
Yes, sir.
There is purpose to your process.
Yes, sir.
You might have made mistakes. You might have failed, but you're here. He hasn't failed you yet. So I want you to just close your eyes. Jesus didn't come to make Christians. He didn't come to create a new religion. He didn't even come to save humanity. Did you know that? Jesus didn't come to save humanity. Only human beings would be that prideful as to think it's all about us. Jesus came to restore creation.
Wow.
There's an entire world that Paul says is waiting for the revealing of the sons of God, the children of God. He didn't come to make a new religion. He came because he loves you and he's tired of seeing creation cry out in pain and dying in the lost state of directionlessness, aimlessness, just existing. Some of you are waking up every day and you put on a smile, you put on a mask. Everything sounds like it's okay, but the truth is you're not okay. And when you go to bed at night after spending an entire day acting for the entire world, performing on the stage of humanity, you finally get to bed, put on your pajamas, and in the darkness of that moment when you're finally alone and you don't have to act anymore, you ask yourself, is this all there is to life? Some of you are here right now and you say, it is not possible that God could love me unconditionally. I have to do something to earn it back because the mistakes that I've made are too great. Not realizing that your greatest days of your mess are actually the foundation for the greatest days of your message.
Wow.
Just like Paul. So Jesus gives an invitation. He says, follow me. With every eye closed, he came so that you don't have to exist anymore. You can live. Following Jesus is as simple as playing the game, Simon says. Follow him. And if you're here today and you say, man, Chris, honestly, the truth is when I'm alone, I know. I don't follow him. It's not about knowing him. Demons know him. The devil knows him. It's not about knowing him. It's not even about believing in him. Demons believe in him. The devil believes in him. Salvation is not knowing or believing. Salvation is following him.
That's good.
Follow him with your life. And if you're here this morning, you say, Chris, I'm not following him. I'm following me. I do what I want. I call myself a Christian. I said the prayer. I go to church. Or I didn't say the prayer. I don't go to church. But whatever it is, I rule me. But today, I want to start fresh. I want to follow him. If that's you, with every eye closed, I just want you to raise your hand and say, Chris, that's me. I'm not a follower of Jesus, but I want to be. I see your hand. Anybody else? I see your hand. Anybody else? I want to follow Jesus. I see your hand. Anybody else? Come on. I see your hand. Anybody else? I'd like for all of us to stand up. And this is what we're going to do. I'm not going to do this big altar call. I'm going to ask our ushers to bring the communion table, and we're going to put it right in the middle. There are very few things that we do that are traditional. But this is one that Jesus said to do, so we should do it. I'm not going to have you come up to the front. I'm not going to do this whole emotional thing with you. And I'm not going to give you goosebumps and make you cry. And then you walk out of here and you're going to be so goosebumpy, but you're just going to go back to your same life and do your same thing. I want to ask you to make a commitment. And as we celebrate the day that Jesus came down to earth to set in motion the reason why we can be here today, we're going to remember his birth by remembering his death. So what is communion? It's bread, a wafer, and juice. Or wine. But we do juice. The bread symbolizes his body broken on the cross for you. And then the juice represents his blood. The sacrifice he made in your place. So this is what we're going to do. I'm supposed to take up offering. I want to combine it all into one act of giving. Can we do that? So what we're going to do is we're going to have the ushers with the offering baskets on one side. Okay? You guys just stand to the side of the stage here. And as you come up, if you have your offering, there's a bunch of different ways you can do it. They'll put it on the screen. I'm not going to read it all off to you. There's a bunch of different ways we can do it. If you have it in physical form, in an envelope you want to give, as you come up and get the communion elements, as you get ready to give your hearts and your lives to Christ, then as a symbol of part of that, we give of our hearts, we give of our time, we give of our resources, and this is one way we do it. Then you can just give it as you go back to your seats. And that's all I'm going to say about that. But don't just come up and take communion. I don't get extra points in heaven if everybody here takes communion today. If you are not making a commitment to follow Jesus, or if you are not following Jesus with your life and you have no desire to do so, I won't judge you. I'm going to keep loving you, and I do love you. But don't come up and do this. If you don't want to follow Jesus, don't come up and do this. But I hope everyone comes up and does this. So I'm going to pray for us, and then we'll start. You guys can just line up, come down the center aisle, and we'll take communion together. Amen? All right, I know I kept you guys here a long time, but we have a special for you to close us out in this communion. So, Father, right now, I just pray that this wouldn't be an empty ritual. I just pray, Father, that this would be a life-changing moment, God, as we remember you, your birth, your death, your resurrection, your life. And I pray, Father, right now that our lives would never be the same again. That we would walk out of here and not just call ourselves Christians. We wouldn't say that we're part of a church or a religion, but that we would be followers of you. And I pray that we would link arms with every other believer in the earth today who says it is all about you. You are Lord of my life. I give you all of me. I don't give you 99%. I don't give you most of me. I give you all of me. I give you my will, my heart, my emotions, my mind, my strength. I give it all to you today. I lay down my life. and I live for you. Because I am tired of doing it on my own. I am tired of just existing. I am tired of walking like a zombie all the way through life, waiting to die. I am ready to live for purpose. I am ready to live with passion. I am ready to live for something more than me. And one day I'm going to look back at my life and say, wow, God, I didn't get to redo my past, but you redeemed it. And made me something special in your kingdom. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. You can come forward. Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, "For I have received of the Lord this which I'm also giving to you, that the Lord Jesus, the night on which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he took it, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you.'" Everywhere in the Bible you see bread and it is broken, it always multiplies without fail. Everywhere in the Bible, bread is broken, it multiplies. See, when you think about Jesus dying on the cross, you tend to think about the breaking. You forget about the multiplying. Whether it was feeding 5,000, no matter who it was, every time bread breaks, it multiplies. And the Bible says that Jesus is the first fruit of those who believe. Yeah. Just as he was bread broken, you, when you give him your life, you become bread broken. Every experience in your life that has tried to break you, that has cracked you, it broke you. The enemy tried to break you, but all he succeeded in doing is he succeeded in multiplying you. Everything that has ever broken you, every memory you have of everywhere you broke yourself or somebody broke you, in the hands of God, the breaking becomes multiplying. You didn't die, you didn't fall apart. God has made you greater.
Yes, sir.
Not in spite of the breaking. Not because he healed the breaking, but because of the breaking. Amen. And the reason why that's possible is because he was broken for you. So as we eat this bread, remember the breaking. But I want you to also remember the multiplying. Let's multiply together. Now, when I go to weddings, and I want you to stick with me for a second. It's going to sound irreverent at first, but it is not, I promise you. When you go to a wedding and they celebrate the bride and the groom, the best man gets up and he raises the glass and he says, "I want to give a toast." And he prepares a blessing for the bride and the groom. When Jesus' blood was poured out for you, we remember the death, we remember the sacrifice. But today, I want to celebrate life, new life that his death signified. I don't want it to be sad or depressed. We got enough sad and depressed in church. Ain't nobody like church who can turn something joyous into something depressing. And I am so tired of depressing church. So I'm going to pray. Oh God. And I want us to toast Jesus, if it were. Not in an irreverent way, in a celebratory way. because his blood was poured out. But then 3 days later, he rose again. And because of that, we have life. So I want you to raise your cup with me. Father, today, wow, you look amazing. Movement, you look insane. Father, today, we honor you. We honor what you did for us. Yes. We honor your blood poured out. We honor the covenant that you made with us. We honor you. And we don't honor you by dying where you died. We don't honor you by stopping at the moment that you died on the cross. We don't stop there. We don't stop. If you lost a loved one and you stopped and you died where they died, or if you lost a relationship and you stopped and you've been a walking zombie ever since and you died where that relationship died, I'm here to tell you today that because of what Jesus did, you don't have to stop and you don't have to die where that person died. You don't have to die where that parent died. You don't have to die where that relationship died. You don't have to die where that job died. You don't have to die where that dream died. You don't have to die because his blood was poured out for you. And because he died where you could have died, you can live as he lives. So we honor you today.
Yes,
we
yes.
move from the place that we
yes,
were.
Yes.
Because your blood made it possible for me to live. So as I drink this cup today, we don't just drink it. We're ready to live it.
Yes.
So I speak life. I speak liberty. I speak lineage today, because that is what his blood purchased for us. In Jesus' name, let's drink that together. So powerful. Well, I so appreciate you being here with us. We have one more special thing for you that we want to bless you with as we close out. So I'm going to turn it over to Huali, and I hope you guys are blessed.
The atmosphere is changing. Nothing stays the same. Heaven is waiting for the mention of the name. The Spirit is moving, burning like a flame, healing the broken by the one we proclaim. Raise it up, fill the sky. Chains will fall, mountains move, we lift him high. Speak the name above all other names. Speak the name the wind and waves obey. All the heavens coming down, fill the earth with the sun. Gather all who wander, hostages of shame. Miracles unfolding at the mention of your name. Now darkness is fleeing, mercy riding down. Healing waters flowing as our lips make the sound. Praise it up, fill the sky. Oh, chains will fall, mountains move, we lift him high.
I've been made free. I am forgiven. Fear has to leave. Strongholds are broken. I've been made free. I am forgiven. Fear has to leave. Your name is healing. Your name is power. Your name is holy. My strong, strong tower. Wonderful name. Glorious name. Powerful name of Jesus. Jesus, speak the name.
Jesus.